Consider now the data that we're going to use. We're going to have features that we've computed. These are things like Bollinger Bands and momentum and price change and things like that. We're going to use these features to try and predict prices or price changes. So this is our X data, and if we've got multiple features, we've got multiple dimensions in X. So this might be X1, X2, X3, and so on. And this is our Y data, which we're trying to predict. In order to evaluate our learning algorithms in a scientific manner, we need to split this data into at least two sections, a training section and a testing section. If we trained over the same data that we tested over, the results would be suspicious because we should obviously be able to do very well if we test over the same data we train on. This procedure of separating testing and training data from one another is called out-of-sample testing. This is a very important and essential technique. We'll call the X data that we use for training X-train, and the Y data that we use for training Y-train. Similarly, the data we'll test on will be split into X and Y sections, X-test and Y-test. So the general idea here is that we'll take our X-train data and our Y-train data, run that through our machine learning algorithm, which might be linear regression or KNN, to generate a model. We can then test the accuracy of that model using this data. So the input to the model is X test. So we plug that X data into the model and out comes something, some kind of Y. And the question is that Y equal to this Y, which we know is ground truth? So the more closely the model outputs a Y that reflects this X test data, the more accurate the model is. Something that I didn't mention is that in this class, our data is time-oriented. So as we move downward, we're going forward in time. So we typically split the data up according to time. So we train our model on older data and test it on newer data. It's generally frowned upon to do the reverse. You might argue, well, this data is different than that data. It's still out of sample. But there are certain look-ahead biases that can occur if you were to train on later data and test on earlier data.